What's going on, guys? It's your boy, Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer, and this is my 23rd weapon review from Ubisoft's latest release, The Division. Today I'm going to be taking a look at the SCAR-H Marksman Rifle, but before I get into the review, here are some basic stats and weapon info for you on the SCAR-H. The country of origin is Belgium. The rate of fire is 275 rounds per minute. The magazine is 20 rounds. The fire type is semi-auto only. And the reload speed is 3.0 seconds. Entering service in 2009 and originally designed by Fabrique Nationale de Herstal for the US SOCOM, the FN SCAR rifles are constructed to be completely modular, including barrel changes to switch between calibers. FN developed two different versions of the SCAR, which include the Mark 16 or SCAR-L or light variant, which I covered in review number 15, and the SCAR-H or heavy variant, also known as the Mark 17. SOCOM originally planned to use both the L and H versions, but later canceled their purchase of the L versions and planned to remove the rifle from their inventories by 2013. However, they did continue to purchase and use the heavier H versions due to the reliability, durability, and the use of the heavy-hitting 7.62 by 51mm NATO rounds housed in the newly designed 20-round mag. In real life, the SCAR-H is sometimes referred to as a battle rifle, and while full auto mode is available, it is never used due to the heavy recoil and considerable punishment inflicted on the user. On paper, the high initial stats of 65 accuracy, 25 stability, and an optimal range of 60 meters look promising, and the accuracy stats are one of the highest in the game. However, I think this is a case of a tweener weapon, as the SCAR-H puts out too much damage for an assault rifle, but not enough for a marksman rifle. The SCAR-H would make an excellent starting weapon for a player that's never used a marksman rifle and needs to get the feel and mechanics of how to use one in-game. However, for an experienced player, I found the lack of damage, even for headshots, to be extremely disappointing. I don't like spamming the fire button while using a DMR, and while the SCAR-H will fire just about as fast as you can pull the trigger, it takes multiple hits to down an enemy. Beware of the heavy upwards recoil and allow time for the weapon to settle down. I found the trick to using the SCAR-H is not to try for one-shot headshot kills, but rather to engage targets at medium range and begin firing at my target's belt line and allow the weapon to recoil upwards. This technique allows the greatest possibility of landing all shots on target and dropping your foe. My suggested mods would be anything that increases damage, especially headshot damage and recoil reduction. I'm going to rate the SCAR-H a 3 out of 5 stars. I've used this heavy-hitting battle rifle in many previous FPS titles, and it has always been a formidable weapon. But the Division variant seems to be firing Nerf darts instead of bullets. This weapon really needs to be in the assault rifle classification of weapons as a semi-automatic instead of trying to keep up with the heavier hitting marksman rifles like the SRS and M44. It's a good training weapon for new recruits, but there is nothing this weapon does that another marksman rifle can't do better. As always, I would love to hear your thoughts on this weapon. Feel free to leave your opinions in the comments section below. In addition, if you could take the time to rate the video with a thumbs up, it would be greatly appreciated. If you'd like some more Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer and my weapon reviews in your life, follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/LtBuzzLitebeer. Remember to check my channel daily for updates, and I will leave a link in the description below to the rest of my The Division weapon reviews. Remember, for my channel, likes, comments, subs are loved. This has been your boy Buzz saying peace out.